Good evening, everybody. Let's worship together. Welcome to TNL Live. Just yield. Worship with us through the countdown and pray. God is up to something.
Show me your glory. You are good, good to me. With every step, I'll let your spirit.
And flesh God. worship glory. So deep, so deep, so wide, so wide. Show me your glory, Lord. So deep, Lord. Oh, yeah, da, ba, 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 yes, yeah. I'm going deep. Sing it again. Let your heart cry. Take me deeper.
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Good evening, everybody. Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
We worship you, Lord. We give you glory in this place.
Oh, yes.
You're all I need. Show me your glory. Show me your glory.
Show us your glory.
Show me your glory.
Show us again.
Show us your glory.
Come into our homes.
Come into
show
our homes.
Show us your glory.
Hallelujah. Oh, let's give the Lord a shout.
Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Yes.
Show me.
We just worship you right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we bless your name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We give you glory in this place.
Yes, Lord.
What are we doing for others to
show? Oh my gosh, where are we going? You know the story, the old story, that whatever can go wrong will go wrong when the Spirit is going to move. So those of you that are on our YouTube channel, you probably won't hear me right now. For some reason, something has happened. It doesn't normally happen with YouTube, but there have been some updates on the platform, and some things may have changed since we've been away. So we can't be sure yet. We've tried to rectify it because YouTube is the best platform. But if I could all ask you to go to, we've already done that.
Yes,
hey?
Yes.
To
yes.
Facebook. And if you're already on YouTube watching this, it means it's been rectified and you're all good to go. So, good evening. Let's pray together. Let's worship the Lord.
Usher in your glory, Lord God. Usher in your glory.
I'll just lead us in prayer there.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we just come into this place of just drawing into your presence, Lord God, just seeking out your glory, Lord God, hungering for your glory. The bride comes together, Lord God, and we just bind, Lord, all technical difficulties right now as the ecclesia, as the bride, in the name of Jesus. Yes. We just loose, Lord God, your Holy Spirit to reign over the atmosphere, over our territories, Lord God, over our homes, over our minds, over every technical challenge, Lord God. We just bind that in the name of Jesus, and we say, Holy Spirit, be loosed so that your word will go forth. Your word must go forth. Your word will go forth
as Hallelujah.
It was intended to in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We worship you. We worship you.
Yes,
Hallelujah.
We praise you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Good evening, everybody. It's good to have you with us tonight. We bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
We just want to come on to TNL tonight. We're actually, we're exhausted, but we're excited. Can I put it that way?
Excited.
So we are welcoming all of you in the name of Jesus. Just tell us if YouTube did go live for some reason. It didn't?
No.
Okay. And we've told everyone to hop on. Okay. I don't like hopping onto Facebook. I'd much rather be on YouTube. But hey, whatever works for tonight, that you can hear the word of God released. We will upload this to YouTube at a later stage. But right now, in the name of Jesus, I want you to lift your hands with me. Come on, we have conquered. The grave has been conquered. Death has been conquered. Victory is what we carry. Hallelujah. We can say, oh death, where is your sting? Because victory is that which we carry in our inner being because of what Jesus has already done.
And so even though we walk through valleys of the shadow of death, the word says we will fear no evil,
yeah.
Not because there is none, not because we think we're bigger than that, because we know God is. And so no matter what we have in front of us, we can overcome. But God is calling us as the bride of Christ into a place of authenticity.
There you go.
We have to be honest with ourselves. We have to be honest with each other. And if we can't do that as a starting point, authenticity of who we really are cannot manifest. We will become those that are like some of the prophets that would prophesy in part in truth and other part not in truth. And so we want to make sure that everything we do is done in this right spirit. And that we are, Lord, that we there is nothing hidden that you cannot see. And so, mighty God, right now, we just thank you that your light exposes all darkness, that you are bringing your manifest glory to the earth, that every bit of darkness will be exposed and annihilated by your spirit, God. And so tonight we come into your presence and we say, thank you, Jesus, for what you did at Sozo. Thank you for what you did among your people.
Lord.
Thank you that that is just the beginning of the process as we enter into this spiritual new year of what you're about to do in each of our lives,
yes,
mighty God.
Yes,
we
yes,
bless
yes.
your name tonight.
Bless your
we
name.
Lift up a holy banner right now and we say, thank you, Jesus, that you have given us your victory. Thank you, Lord, for all that is ahead of us, all that is before us, because the mighty hand of the Lord Jesus Christ is with us. Somebody say, I carry a sword in my right hand.
I carry a sword in my right
hand.
And
the word comes out of my mouth.
And the word comes out of my mouth.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
My weapon is my word is the word of God.
Yes.
My weapon is the word of God.
My weapon
Hallelujah.
Is the word of God. Apostle, I just wanted
Come
to
on,
release
please
just
do.
As you said,
please do.
Victory banner. We just wanna speak out Jehovah Nissi right now, our victory banner. I just saw some people needing just a word of encouragement right now, that whatever obstacles have come against you or in your way this week, that we just declare Jehovah Nissi, our victory banner, that we know we have the victory. As Apostle said, we have a sword in our right hand. We're declaring the word of God tonight. We're declaring the Rhema word and the Logos word tonight, so that you may be free, that we may be free, that we position ourselves for purpose in the presence this evening, so that we can receive a word, a Logos and Rhema word, so that we have the word and the revelation, the word and the revelation. Can I just ask someone to put in the comments there, word and revelation, that we just seal that. We just seal that in the spirit. We just seal that in the spirit. Come on, everybody. Let's see those comments, those hearts flying as we come into agreement with the word this evening. Because we believe that there will be solid word release, solid teaching, and then there will be revelation released. And if we're not positioned correctly, we cannot receive that revelation. We may hear the word, but we can't receive the word. I just hear in my spirit right now that we have to process the word. And process means we need to be engaged, right? We need to be connected. So part of you connecting is releasing your hallelujahs, your amens, and just letting us know from time to time, hey, what is the Lord releasing into your spirit? Coming into agreement with the word, receiving that word, receiving the revelation, processing, eating the scroll tonight. That's what I see in my spirit. It will be sweet as we eat the scroll tonight to set our futures and to secure our futures. Amen, Donnie. Yes, I carry a sword
yes,
in my right
yes,
hand,
yes.
declaring God's word.
Yes,
yes Bobo, word and revelation. Thank you for that. Yes, word and revelation. Word and revelation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pat.
Hallelujah.
Word and revelation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We
Woo.
Praise you, Jesus. We
Thank
praise
you Lord.
You, Lord.
Yes.
Powerful, powerful, powerful. Again,
Thank
sorry
you,
to those that were on YouTube. That is our main platform. Just continue with us on Facebook and we'll upload this later for those that have just come on. We welcome you to TNL Live in the name of Jesus tonight. Prophet, I don't know if there's anything else you wanted to go ahead with and I'll come in afterwards or whatever you have first.
Apostle and I were just listening to, and I know that you will speak on that a little bit later on. But just as we carry through some of the revelation that we spoke out over Sozo, the weekend of Sozo, just some words of freedom, some words of encouragement, some words of deliverance. And I just wanted to say that we have to position, right? We have to be positioned in this season. Our posture has to be correct.
Whew.
Now, posture means that we assume a position for a special purpose. So you make up the body of Christ. We're not entities on our own. We're not fly by nights. We're not, what is that word that you always use, Apostle? Lone Rangers. We operate as the body of Christ. We don't operate as lone rangers.
We must be under a covering.
Yes, we're the
ecclesia.
Because
that's our credibility, right?
Yes, we're the ecclesia. We come together to accomplish God's purpose. Each one uniquely called with gifts bestowed upon us and anointing released. But it's the corporate body that will move forward in this season.
Oh.
It won't be the lone rangers. It will be the corporate body of Christ. And in that corporate body of Christ, each individual will play their part to move the ecclesia, to move the bride forward. So I just wanted to say, body of Christ, you've been called for a special purpose in this season and time that is being I was going to say revealed, that is being shown, that is being uncovered. And part of even tonight is just reiterating some of those things and then having further revelation released into that word and onto that word. We must understand and experience Holy Spirit in a new way in this era.
Yes,
I believe that the Lord, remember what I said for those that were attending Sozo, the Lord is synchronizing three things in this season: our eyes, our ears, and our hearts. Because if one of them is missing, we cannot have the full encounter that the Lord wants us to have as the bride of Christ. We can't understand the things of the Spirit the same way or the way that the Lord would have intended for us to do. So there's a synchronization of Ayin, which is eye, Ozen, which is our ears or ear, and then our hearts. So we need to receive that revelation by receiving spiritually with our spiritual eyes, spiritual ears, and then receiving it into the depths of our hearts. Because then we will be able to process that word appropriately, process the revelation, receive the revelation, and activate the revelation. I think, Apostle, I just see in my spirit that many may receive, you know, and we're not going to speak on the parable of the sower, but it just came to mind right now. Must I look there?
No. Okay. No, just keep going.
The parable of the sower is so apt for this season. We have to have those seeds fall in fertile ground, in soil that's been plowed. I hear in my spirit that's been hammered, and I spoke about the hammering process on Saturday when I brought the word. There's a hammering process that's taking place amongst the bride of Christ.
Yeah.
It's a good hammering process because it's breaking open, as Apostle taught us some years back, unplowed ground.
Yes, that's right.
Body of Christ, you have to be of great faith in this season. You have to be fearless. Know that you've been surrounded with favor, and as you receive that, you're able to move forward in this season. Apostle, I just wanted to release that because that posturing has not left me.
Yeah.
We have to be postured to receive the revelation.
Yeah.
And remember, the word posture could be positive, where we position for great assignment. But the other meaning of posture could also mean to assume an artificial or pretend attitude. So we have to be able to discern in this season the fake from the real. We have to be able to discern the real, authentic bride versus those that are just merely pretending.
Yeah.
And trust me, in this season, discernment is going to be key.
Sure.
Thank you, Apostle.
We're going to keep sort of tagging with each other, just in sync with the word that the Lord has given us to release as the prophet and apostle of the network, and tonight as Deborah and Mariki.
Amen.
But we want to encourage you to hear the word of the Lord, because we know that we have our family of TNL on here that are not always. We're going to be doing this for the next month. We're going to be talking about the vision that God has imparted. And I want to tell you what the spiritual and prophetic year is that we're in. It is the year 5783 is the year of the restoration of the bride of Christ. Mm-hmm. It is about the restoration of the church. God is restoring the church to the model of David's tabernacle that we read about in Amos 9:13. And I want to share a little bit with you, and I'm going to share a little bit as we go in time together with you with regards to what we started at Sozo, because I think there is never enough said, and we take some things in but not everything. And I know a lot of people were taking notes, and there was so much that God had laid upon our hearts. So I want to just share a little bit of it. There were three main things that the Lord spoke to my heart about and confirmed. it was so weird. I think on the 2nd of October, let me get to that. The Lord began to speak deeply into my spirit as I was preparing for Sozo and gave me the theme, obviously, was the Spirit and the Bride from Revelation 22:17, and you all know that was the main thrust of the message, because the focus this year is about the Bride of Christ, but not just the Bride of Christ, about the Bride of Christ being empowered by Holy Spirit,
yes,
being moved by Holy Spirit, being literally held and grafted in and with the winds of the Spirit carrying her.
Amen.
See, in the past, a lot of the time, what we've done as the Bride of Christ is we believe that we've been using and riding on the wings of the wisdom of God, but often it's been human wisdom, it's been carnal thought, and that might go into it. But the first thing the Lord wants us to do is get an understanding of the wisdom and revelation that is coming from heaven. And so I'm going to share a few things with you. I'm going to see how far I get. We're going to carry on with this on Sunday. There's a lot that God has imparted to us. It's exciting times that we're living in. So don't be surprised. If you've been under attack, know that the moment you come under spiritual attack, the enemy puts a veil over your eyes, puts a veil over your face so that you cannot hear and you cannot see what the Spirit is saying. You may hear some things carnally, but the voice that you hear is tuned in to sometimes demonic forces, not the voice of the Lord. And so we have to make sure that in this hour and season, we can hear the voice of God much more clearly than we hear any other voice that is coming against us, coming against our churches, coming against the people of God. And it's the time more than ever where we need to be in one heart, one mind, and one spirit,
yes,
in Jesus' mighty name.
In
I'm going to share a few
name.
Things with you, three major things that the Lord gave me. And that is important for us to know, is that we're in the year of the camel, which is pictorially, that's the symbol of Gamel, which is the year that we're in. And really, Gamel, the root word for Gamel is to give out. And that's why the Lord just gave me this scripture, because the Bride of Christ has to sow into the soil of the church in this coming hour.
That's good.
You know, we talk about reaping the blessings, and we want the blessings, and we're walking by faith. But what are we sowing? What are we sowing to the Lord? What is our heart of gratitude? We know in Luke 38, the word says, give and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over, it will be poured out into your lap. For with the measure you use, you will be measured. And so we are in a time of blessing and judgment. So the nature of our giving can lead to either blessing or judgment, not by others, but by God. And so how we choose to run our race in this next season will determine how much of that blessing we receive. And it's all determined by our walking in obedience to the will of God. We're not measured by our works. We're measured by our hearts. We're measured by the faith walk that we walk. We measured by obedience, not by works. Be
amen.
Careful
amen.
That you don't mix those two things up.
Yeah, amen.
So Gamel is a free choice for us to exercise loving kindness. So the enemy is at, some people may be pulling their hair out with their partners, with their wives, with their husbands, with their friends, with their churches, There is such demonic attack going on right now. It happens before Sozo and after Sozo because we're in apostolic prophetic work. And therefore, what happens is when you come into church, you shouldn't be leaving the same.
Amen.
There should be healing and deliverance taking place in your life so that Romans 12:2 can take effect, which is the transforming work of Holy Spirit changing us from the inside out, from the inside to the outside. And so the prophetic word of Gimel is really about us embracing the realm of the Spirit, and that it's a season of sowing our seed for the harvest of souls.
Amen.
So there's an evangelical call on the church that I spoke about at Sozo. And so Gimel is also, another word for Gimel, is also a picture of Holy Spirit. And prophetically, this year is a year of the divine habitation of the house of God, meaning that last year we spoke about the divine habitation of Jesus Christ the Son. And that doesn't mean that Jesus Christ doesn't have focus. It just means that that the Lord was starting to line things up in the church, aligning us. I heard another prophet say that God was busy aligning the church, aligning the church, aligning the church, yes, over these years to prepare us for the mission that is ahead. So it's not just one spiritual year to another. There are prophetic words released 5 years ago, 4 years ago, that are coming to pass now. All of it is to do with alignment of purpose. And so it's the divine habitation of Holy Spirit in the house of God. That's why it's about the Spirit and the bride. It's about us being propelled into the next level of glory that God has for us. And so the vision for our network that the Lord has given me for 5783 is this restoration of the bride of Christ. If you can just remember that one thing, that one sentence, that we are in the year of the restoration of the bride of Christ, everything will make sense because you will already have a building block to where we are going. This is our key scripture, Revelation 22:17, and it says this, Revelation 22:17, and you can put it up there if anybody's got it.
Revelation 22:17.
The Spirit and the bride say, come. And let the one who hears say, come. And let the one who is thirsty come. And let the one who wishes to take the free gift. Somebody say free gift.
Free gift.
Write it down.
Free
gift. Of the water of life. Water here means the Spirit. It's talking about Holy Spirit. Those who take the free gift of the water of the Spirit. Now, let me just share with you. When we talk about Holy Spirit in Matthew 3:11, the Word of God says that after John the Baptist had come to prepare the way, that there would be one coming after him, he prophesied, whose sandals he would be unfit to untie. And he said, and he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. So we're not just talking about being filled with the Holy Spirit, speaking in tongues, and having an Acts 2 experience, although many of us still long for that, even though we haven't maybe have had somewhat of an experience. It's going to be bigger than Acts chapter 2. It's this move of God, and we've seen it. We've seen it prophesied over the years, but there is no time that I have ever felt closer, yeah, to what God is doing now, and no time, yes, I've felt more excitement apart from 5 years ago,
yep,
that I feel now in terms of, amen, what God is doing. We're on a cutting edge of something new in the church. Amen.
Yes.
And so the Lord is not saying, hey, listen, the Spirit is just going to come to all the churches. The Lord is saying, I'm coming to those that are hungry. I'm coming to those who want more. I'm coming to those who really want to change, who really want to become more like me, yeah, who really want to develop a nature and character and get rid of anger issues and things that have held you back and thoughts that hold you captive that are not of God. Amen?
Yes, 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 yes.
So John the Baptist came to prepare the way for the first coming of Jesus. The bride of Christ is getting ready to prepare the way for the second coming. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Now the word for spirit here, the Greek word you all know is pneuma, and it means breath. It means to blow. And what I said at Sozo is that it also means a movement of air, a movement of air. I might sound like I'm going quickly, but I know that you're going to get this. And if you were at Sozo, you're going to get it again, and you're going to get a lot of things that you didn't get. Hallelujah. And so you're going to have to come on Sunday or watch on Sunday if you're somewhere else to get the rest of this. But it means a movement of air because the Spirit is life-giving.
Yes.
The Spirit breathes life. The Spirit is not dead. The Spirit brings movement. Life to the church.
Yep.
And therefore, it is about movement. Somebody say, there is about to be movement in the body of Christ.
There's about to be movement in the body of Christ.
To some extent, yes. The bride of Christ has been asleep, but now she's about to awaken.
Amen.
And movement is happening. Somebody write movement.
Movement.
So the prophetic year ahead for the Spirit in the bride is about the manifestation of Holy Spirit in the body of Christ, with the fire of God being set apart in the church and in our bellies. From out of our bellies will flow living water. And another word for water is Spirit. And so we're talking about the fire of God being set upon the church. It's about the Holy Spirit working in the church. And I said something, I said it's a new day. Not only are we going a new way, but it's a new day for the church. Often prophetically, that word, that term new day, it's a whole new era that we're in one sense of the word. Because there's an end time army arising. The glory of God is about to manifest in the church in greater measure.
Yes.
The Lord wants to take you and I to new levels of glory. But who's going to want glory if we're not hungry? See, the enemy wants to stop you hungering after the deep things of God. So he puts every distraction in your way. You know, people that love you can warn you about things. They can say, listen, be careful. There's these temptations. There's these things ahead of you. But only you can make the right decisions. Only you can make the right choices. One way will lead you another way.
Yeah.
One set of choices will lead you one way, and another set of choices will lead you into your destiny and purpose. This is a deciding moment we are in the church right now.
That's
we have come to a crossroads spiritually where the church has to make her mind up. People, we have to make our mind up. Which way are we going? What direction are we going? There's no time for wishy-washy. God is moving us into a place to make the bride ready for the second coming of Christ. It's a time of revealing and unveiling.
Amen, amen, absolutely.
It's a great movement that's permeating the earth right now.
Yeah.
Great movement.
And I think, Apostle, that synchronization of eyes, ears, and heart.
Come on.
That revealing and unveiling. I must be careful now, but
sure.
I know that you will put it in context. I just saw in my spirit, it can't be seen by everybody. Can't be experienced by anybody. It's those who have synchronized hearts, eyes, ears.
Yeah.
Bride of Christ, church, family, people of God, whatever resonates with you, I'm going to ask you to just touch your heart right now to say, Lord, I want to be part of the end time movement. Because that movement is so key for the bride in its awakened state. That movement is going to increase in momentum.
Sure.
And as it increases, I hear in my spirit, you've got to stay with the program. You've got to stay with the speed that the Lord is moving at.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if you don't, you can't experience the fullness of what the Lord is doing in this season and time.
Yeah.
The revealing and the unveiling can only be for those who have said, Lord, open my eyes, my ears, my heart.
Yeah.
For I want to see, I want to hear, and I want to encounter and experience.
Yeah.
Then the unveiling and the revealing, Deborah, can be in fullness upon the bride.
Yeah.
And the movement is understood by us.
Yes, yes.
The pace is understood by us. The speed is understood by us. We're not moving ahead.
Yeah.
But we're not moving behind either. We are
sure.
moving with Holy Spirit.
And there has to be movement, Prophet. There has to be movement. You know, when we look at Ezekiel 37 and we see the tendons and the skin being put onto the bones were dead, dry bones. And then the Spirit of God in the vision said to him, prophesy over these bones.
Prophesy.
We're in a season where we are going to prophesy a thing and it's going to come to pass as Romans 4:17 says. But I'm telling you now, it's going to come from the authentic hearts of those who have been called on assignment to speak a prophetic word, recognized voices of the Most High God. Yeah. Because we have to prophesy some things that we have taken and left authority of prophecy. To some extent, we've prophesied some nice things, but we need to prophesy some things, some movement back into the church, because there had to be movement for Ezekiel 37 to happen. There had to be movement for those tendons to come back on those bones, but it happened when he prophesied, prophesy that those dry bones would live. They were dead, but he prophesied that they would live, and they began. Those tendons began to come, and the flesh began to get onto those bones. And then, lastly, the breath of God breathed new life into those bones, and they came to life. Were prophesied over. The winds of the Spirit are blowing right now in the midst of us. A movement of worship is forming.
Yes.
There is a movement forming in the body of Christ, in the ecclesia. There is a movement forming in the bride of Christ of the Holy Spirit. And we are being carried on the wind of the Spirit in this time. For those that are hungry, the church has been in transition, prophet.
Yeah.
It's been in transition, but now we are awakening. Do you remember last year that the theme was Fires of Awakening?
Yes.
Or the year before, I get caught up with COVID, forgetting what year we're in. And that Fires of Awakening still stands. The Lord said, I'm going to have to plow some unplowed ground. In other words, there is some soil sometimes in our hearts, in the life of the church, that is so hard. Some of us don't even have self-awareness about some of the things in our lives where we need to plow and break some unplowed soil so that our hearts can be softened to the degree where Holy Spirit can begin to move freely again in our lives, so that we are activated as the body of Christ for movement of the Holy Spirit to begin to shift us into where we need to be in the glory realm. Somebody say, in the glory realm.
In the glory realm.
Somebody say, I'm shifting, not sifting.
I'm shifting, not sifting.
Hallelujah. Because the Bible says the latter glory will be greater than the former. And we have prophesied that. Others have prophesied that. We believe we're moving into those days where the latter glory will be greater than the former.
I just wanted to add that we know that sound precedes, in many instances, revival. And I just saw in my spirit, just as you released that, Apostle, that the movement of sound is going before us to break open some things that could not break open previously. An apostle spoke about freedom to us as people, as deliverance, as unplowed ground. I heard right now that the confessions in the season of our hearts will become key to breaking open things that were locked in shame, in guilt, in the shadows.
Sure.
That sound of the confession, that sound of the declaration will open up and break those things open over us and over our lives, so that we can be part of the movement.
Ooh, rabababa shakaba.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. So the first thing was the Lord showed me that it's the Spirit and the Bride, the Holy Spirit, that is activating, that the Bride of Christ is being restored. So the second thing that the Lord showed me is, and put into my spirit, is chariots of fire. Chariots of fire. Someone say, chariots of fire are coming.
Chariots of fire are
Chariots of fire are coming. Now, prophetically, I mentioned, and I shared a bit of this at Sozo, that prophetically, these chariots symbolize instruments of war, but they also symbolize the power and glory of God. And so I said that we're not at the end of a warfare era. We're still in an era of warfare, But the line of the tribe of Judah goes before us and is blowing down the sound that you were talking about, prophet, of heaven to change the course of the church. Someone say, it's time for the bride of Christ to change course. Come on, God is downloading things into our spirit. Many of us have been dry for a season, but there, when we wait on the Lord, we will renew our strength.
Yeah.
And the time for the body of Christ to arise has come. The time for her to take her place, to prepare the way for the Lord has come. And right now, the bride is arising to new levels of glory. Now, I want to talk to you a bit about these chariots of fire. The Lord gave me this word actually some time back, a couple of weeks ago, and I shared it with Prophet. And I think on what was our first night, Friday? Was it 30th? On the 30th of September, I shared that word on chariots of fire in my keynote as I began to impart the vision for the network to the churches at Sozo. And then I was looking through some stuff earlier. I was looking for something else, and I came across somebody else speaking on 5783. I think it was Tim Sheets. I can't remember exactly what it was, but I remember that it was the 2nd of October. So it was 2 days later. So it was on Sunday, and he began to talk about a vision that the Lord gave him just recently, and of course it was made public on this broadcast, 2nd of October, things that I spoke out on, and I love it when the Lord confirms the word. And he started to talk about the Lord releasing chariots of fire. And I don't know if we know this, but we've been dealing in the church with strongholds of mammon. In other words, we've been held back by finances, by not having resources, and also religion, a religious spirit that has permeated the church. And the spirit is about to break off some things. So don't listen, just go ouch and amen anymore. Just go amen. Just say hallelujah, amen. Just say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know we've been having a laugh with our Cape Town people about that. Now, I want to explain something to you about these chariots of fire. They are angels that have been dispatched from heaven, and they are the seraphim. These are the highest level of angels, like the angel Gabriel, the highest level of angels that have been commissioned to come to the bride of Christ, commissioned. The Lord showed me this commission to come to the from heaven to the bride of Christ, chariots of fire. They're often called angels of fire. They're often called the burning ones, the seraphim, and they're often called the fiery ones or the flaming ones. And so the angels are being sent on assignment to war on our behalf. That is why the Lord showed me, just gave me this word, chariots of fire, and then began to explain it to me. Because there are 10,000 upon 10,000 upon 10,000. And why was this word so important? It only began to be expounded to me later on. It was the Lord then showed me and gave me a word when I started looking up scripture for this, when it came to chariots of fire, because of course we all know the movie Chariots of Fire, and I'm like, Lord, is it just my kind of artistic flair? I need to know this is from you. And then the Lord gave me Psalm 68:17 says, the chariots of God are tens of thousands and thousands of thousands. The chariots of God are tens of thousands of thousands and thousands. The Lord has come from Sinai into the Lord's sanctuary. Now, why is this so important? Because the chariots of fire not only symbolize the Lord sending the seraphim, the highest level of angels, angelic hosts, warring angels. They are actually called the special forces. They are the special force special angels, forces. If you like. Special forces of heaven being released to us. But what was so important about Psalm 68 was how the Lord brought this round in terms of chariots of fire, is that the psalm is connected to when David brought the ark, when it had been stolen, and David brought the Ark of the Covenant, the very presence of God that dwelt in the Ark of the Covenant, brought it back to Jerusalem that we read about in 2 Samuel chapter 6. And they were celebrating God's faithfulness to give Israel victory over her enemies. We must celebrate ahead of time God's faithfulness, that God has given us victory over our enemies. We may still be in the midst of the battle, but the Lord is preparing a table for you in the midst of your enemies.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what may become you or befall you. God is preparing a table. What does that mean? You can rest in the Lord in spite of your situation and where you find yourself. Because bride of Christ, you are about to be strengthened beyond measure.
Amen.
You're about to inherit the double portion of blessing and fire if you are hungry enough and you desire it. Listen, don't desire it more than you desire to change everything about yourself that God needs to change in the process. Don't just desire the gifts of the Spirit, but the changing of what the Spirit of God will do in you.
Amen.
So even though we're in a spiritual battle, we know that Matthew 16 teaches us that the word says, my church will prevail and the gates of hell will not prevail against her. She will be the prevailing church. But I believe that the church that will prevail in this hour and in this season will be the church that hosts the presence of God, that hosts the presence of Holy
Amen.
Spirit.
Amen.
Come on, someone say, Lord, let me host your presence wherever I go. I want to be a flaming fire for you. I want to be one that releases fire when I speak your name. I want to be one, Lord, that is able to take hold of the presence of God and move to these new levels of glory. That I am immersed in what you are showing and saying. The prevailing church will prevail. So the chariots symbolize the warfare, but also the fire of God that is being poured out and empowering the body of Christ in this coming era. Amen?
Amen.
They're fires of revival and awakening, prophet, as you said. Fires of awakening and glory. Hallelujah.
Yes.
The Lord is releasing a new fire. I said that on at Sozo. A new fire of the Spirit on the bride of Christ. What is that? That's that Matthew 11. The Lord is coming and will baptize you with the Spirit of God and with fire. The Spirit of God is one thing. We all have that as believers. Only as believers do you carry the Spirit of God. But that has to be activated by the fire of God. Somebody say, I'm getting this.
I'm getting this.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Did you want to say
Jesus,
anything? I'm nearly done.
Jesus.
I remember just saying something that the church is going to, the prevailing church that carries the presence and the fire of God in this hour is going to be like the Gideon company, a Gideon company church. In other words, people will go, my gosh, how did they get through that? How did they, where's that? When I walk in there, I feel the presence of God. I'm not the same. I'm hungry. I'm desirous. And the Gideon company is that which showed that it could never be in human strength that they prevailed. The army only prevailed. They had 300 men left. God said, no matter that you've got 10,000, get rid of them all. I'm going to watch the behavior of them when they lick the water from the brook. And if they behave in a certain way, I'm going to tell you, get rid of those. These are the ones you must keep. And out of an army of 10,000, there were only 300 that were left. You all know the story. But the Lord did that on purpose because the Lord wanted to show Gideon and all the world that with a small army, they could succeed and overtake the enemy because God went ahead of them. In other words, there was supernatural intervention. That's what's going to happen in the church in this coming hour. God's going to supernaturally intervene for the church that will carry the presence.
Yeah. Also, I just wanted to add that. When that sifting process has taken place, first in our own lives.
Sure.
Where we're able to let go of those things that hindered, that harmed ourselves and possibly others.
Yeah.
When that sifting process is underway, it may not be complete yet. We're able to step into the process which you've just explained, Apostle, to be part of that end time bride, that end time people who will bring in that end time harvest.
Sure.
But we've got to get to a place where the sifting also happens in our own lives.
Shifting.
Sifting and then shifting is what I heard in my spirit. I know you said we're not sifting, we're shifting.
But there are some that may have to sift.
Correct,
some things. Yes.
Correct. And I believe that will be the kind of almost moment where you will make that shift. Because we can't separate the two.
Yeah.
We have to bow low in this season. We have to bow low in this season.
Sure.
To be able to understand and hold the glory, hold the presence as the bride of Christ.
Sure.
And that whittling down, that sifting, I agree, like the Lord did with Gideon. It is to show God's greatness and glory amongst the bride.
Yeah.
Who's raised up in purity.
And why that's so important, Prophet, is because in this hour, like with Gideon's army, and that's why I say we like a Gideon company, because the people that God said to Gideon keep, that small remnant of 300, were people that were walking in unity.
Yes.
With Gideon's vision and heart.
Yeah.
That would follow their instructions onto the field with the strategies of heaven that had been released to Gideon. Because otherwise it would have been this one doing their own thing. And that's why it's been likened to the body of Christ right now. Because the body of Christ is being aligned, even
yes.
by these angel armies, even by these special force armies that are being released from heaven, the angels in the chariots of fire, to align the body of Christ. That's why we've been talking about positioning.
Yes.
And posture.
Yes.
Posture is also about attitude of heart. It's about not having an entitled spirit, but knowing that God is going to take us through if we will just submit to the Lord.
Amen.
And just saying, Lord, in your time, everything will take place. But what do you want from me now? What do you want from me now?
What do you want from me now?
And I believe what the Lord wants from us right now is all of us to lay ourselves down. That's the word that God's been speaking to the church. Because the church cannot be in unity. The enemy will try everything to bring disunity right now into the body of Christ. You better believe it. If you thought that it happened in the past, look, you're always going to get the odd people. You know, there's going to be people that say things and do things. That's the nature of the revolving door of the global church. It is what it is in that sense. But I can say this much to you. You've got to go after those that are hungry. You've got to look them in the eye and say, listen, the Lord is recruiting you.
Amen.
The Lord is recruiting you because this is a privilege to serve in the body of Christ in this hour. I am telling you, we are a privileged generation. And I'm not just talking about generation and age. I'm talking about a spiritual, prophetic generation that we are living in an age and a time that many have not seen.
Yes.
We are going to see a manifestation not only of revival and fires of awakening, of the glory of God, but the new levels of glory. I believe it's going to be much greater than the book of Acts.
Amen.
And so we need to be in a position where we are coming into unity as the body of Christ. You can only be unified if you're in one heart and one spirit, because it's being in one spirit that unifies us. And we can never have clarity of spiritual thought if we will not be unified if there are things in our lives that are causing a distraction and causing us to shift from the presence of God, or causing us to hear the wrong voices. We need to make sure we are delivered in this season, that we repent in this season, that we make right our wrongs, that we get ready to lay ourselves down so that we can be lifted up as the Lord is the lifter of our heads. The
yes.
third thing I want to quickly give you, this is very quick, that the Lord gave me. It was the Spirit and the Bride. It was the chariots of fire. And the third thing, it was the seven fat ewes. For some
Hallelujah.
Time you've heard me talking about this vision that the Lord gave me, that the church has been in spiritually, prophetically, seven lean years. And we know certainly for us, we can say that in between, there's been amazing amounts of glory, amazing memories, and all of the things that God has done. None of those go to waste. We must never forget that. But there's been some hard times that have befallen the church, where our storehouses haven't been full, where we haven't been able to receive the resources that have been prophesied over our churches for years. But I am telling you now, the Lord showed me, just like in Genesis, where we know that Joseph was called to interpret Pharaoh's dream, and we know it was the other way around, that there were first the fat ewes and it was the fat cows, and he began to say, yes, it is the Lord saying, store up your grain and put it away in the vats so that they can be ready. In the silos, so that it can be ready for when the famine comes, because a 7-year famine is coming. So take the 7 fat ewes and allow those fat cows and all of that to be harvested so that you can allow for extra. Ours is working in reverse. There have been many lean ewes, but now the Lord is saying, sow into the fat ewes. Begin to sow into the fat ewes. Sow financially, not just financially. The Lord wants you to sow of yourself. It's about your time. It's about how willing you are to give. It's about the willingness of heart. This is a season where we talk about the spirit of generosity being that which God blesses in the church. I am telling you, you may think of it as something small, but Jesus never spoke about homosexuality at all. But he did speak about hospitality. And I want to tell you now, we are moving into 7 fat years, the years of plenty, the years where the camels are coming, Amen. The years where God is going to begin to fill our storehouses, replenish resources yes. that were lost or stolen. Come on, we are Hephzibah. The word in Isaiah 62 means we are God's delight. God is about to pour out abundant grace on the body of Christ where the presence of God dwells. In other words, where the hungry are. Abundance where the hungry grace. Are. Because we won't appreciate it if we are not those that are hungering. We're not going to appreciate what the Lord is giving us. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So get ready that we are moving into a time of abundant grace, of resources being bestowed upon the house. But I want to share with you, the caveat is that we need to be generous givers.
Generous
not just
givers.
Our finances, that's absolutely essential. But we need to become those that are givers of ourselves, givers of our time. Saying to the Lord, Lord, I'm coming into my house. I'm going to go to my leaders and I say, where do you need to use me? How can I be used? Not just where I want to be. Not just who I've got stars in my eyes about the pulpit. I've got people don't even realize you have to be faithful. The scripture says in the little things and be proved faithful before the Lord gives you the much. That's what scripture says. And that's the principle by which all of us as leaders grow and hewn and mentor our people. Because we are talking about the house of God. We're not going to put that into the wrong hands. And so we want to come into a place where we are ready to be givers of ourselves, to do yes. whatever the Lord wants. Lord, you want me to what? You want me to clean the toilets? Lord, I thought you were preparing me for the pulpit. Yes, I am. Go clean the toilets. So come on, we've got to be able to serve. If yes. we can't serve, we can't expect others to serve us. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So there are heavenly gifts that we're talking about, not just physical resources, but the heavenly gifts
Amen.
That Ephesians 1 talks about that are coming from the heavenly realms that are being released. The key of David that we know about in Isaiah 22 being released. What is that? That's the key, listen carefully, that opens doors that no one can shut.
Yes.
That opens doors that, yes. listen, we're in a season of open doors.
Come on.
But there are other caveats. There is a combination lock that only certain things will open that door. And I believe that is going to be about our hearts. It's going to be about having a pure motives of heart. It's going to be about how hungry we are for the presence and what we really want. Because God's not going to give us something we don't really want.
Yeah.
And so I'm asking you to seek the Lord, because the keys of David are being unleashed. And it opens doors that no one can shut. And there are also doors that have remained locked. I think we prophesied this last year or the year before as well, that have such hundreds of locks on them, almost like ancient gates.
Yes.
And we prophesied this, I think, last year online when it came to the new year. And as we move into 5783 and we've just shifted into it, we had the Day of Atonement yesterday, which was one of the holiest days of the year, not just religiously or ritualistically, but meaning that we understand what these times and seasons are for. Moving into them, God sets them apart so we can come into alignment as the body of Christ, because we always need realigning. Come on, we always need realigning. And so these heavenly gifts are being bestowed, and ancient gates and ancient doors are being unlocked. Doors that you prayed and fasted for
yes.
before, that you couldn't understand why they haven't opened. Some of you may have even lost faith, but this season,
yeah.
they are about to be supernaturally opened. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is going to give you a breakthrough for new provision this year. A breakthrough for new for new provision this year. Hallelujah.
Yes, breakthrough for new
Come
provision.
Come on, it's the restoration of the bride of Christ. If you can just put that up for us, yes. Prophet. It's a restoration for the bride of Christ. Come on, we're in a season of the restoration of the bride of Christ, where the supernatural power of Holy Spirit is being activated, the winds of the Spirit on the four corners coming from the four corners into the earth, and the chariots of fire that are being led by the warring angels, the seraphim, the highest level of angels that are being sent on commission by heaven, by the Lord of glory, for your and my churches, for our benefit, for the people of God, for the ecclesia, for the bride of Christ to arise and take her place. God is releasing fire and glory on the church. Say, I receive it right there. Fire and glory are
fire
coming.
And glory.
Fire and glory are coming. Shanamarabashaka. The other thing I saw as part of this is that God was releasing new garments of glory that were being released.
Yes.
New garments of glory. Now, this came as a bit of an afterthought, but it's part of, it's probably number four, new garments of glory. And it came out of Joshua 3. If you go read it, you'll read the word that came to him. And so the first thing we have to do before we receive a new garment is we have to take off the old garment. And what the Lord showed me at Sozo is that some of us want to keep the old garments and then still have the new garment. And the Lord said, you cannot. You have to be willing to take that old garment off. And for some of you right now that are online with us, I want you to know that God is calling us to take off our old garments. Some of you may say, but this is a holy garment. This is what the Lord gave me in the last season. This, the Lord's saying, take it off. That season for that garment is over. I'm putting on a new garment of glory, and it's being released upon you right now. But you cannot have it both ways. The old garment must come off. So right now, let's do that right now. Let's do a prophetic act. Because the fire and glory is going to be released. The fire and glory is going to be released. The fire and glory is going to be released. Hallelujah. Come, let's get into some. Let's move right now. Lift your hands with me, body of Christ. Lift your hands. Lift your hands with us as we come into a place right now. Say, I'm taking off my old garment, even physically. Picture yourself taking off that old garment and think to yourself right now, what do those old garments mean? What do those old garments mean? Right now, what do those old garments mean for you? What do they mean for you? What do they mean for you? What do they mean for you right now? It could be some past iniquitous patterns in your life. You have to just be honest about it right now, and you have to take them off. The Lord is calling us to a place of repentance. Those old garments, before you put on the new ones, require us to do some repenting. They require us to do some repenting. Hallelujah. Someone say, I am going to repent. I'm going to make right. If there's somebody you need to make right with, come on. You may have spoken a curse over people. You may have spoken a curse over your own church. You may have spoken a curse over your leaders. You may have spoken a curse over your family. You may have spoken a curse over your spouse. Come on, that's part of your old garment. You have to release that right now. You have to repent of that. That is part of your old garment. You have to give it to the Lord right now. Tell the Lord what it is. Where we are standing is hallowed ground. Where we are standing is hallowed ground. We're standing on hallowed ground. Fire and glory is about to be released over the bride of Christ. Over the bride of Christ. The Lord, the Spirit and the bride say, come. Who's the Lord calling? Only those that are hungry and thirsty. Not anybody else. Those that are hungry and thirsty. The Lord wants all to come. The Lord wants us all to hunger and thirst, but it must be out of the desire of our own hearts. Thanks, Prophet. Come on, Spirit and the Bride, say come. The Spirit and the Bride are calling you. The Spirit and the Bride say, come. Shukamashe, hashe, Oh, Rabbi, I see some people putting on there right now. I'm going to repent. I'm going to make right. Come on, you know there are people that you need to make right with. Part of our spiritual growth is bringing our pride and putting it outside. Come on, it doesn't belong in the house of God. Spirit of pride. Sometimes we struggle because we know that the people we have to confront know who we are. And we need to trust that the Lord will take care of things when we do it the right way. So right now, I want you to make right with whoever that may be. Just repent to the Lord and then make sure that straight after this broadcast, even now, you just go to that person, that go to that family member, go to that spouse, go to that partner, make right. Don't let the enemy bring anything between you. Come on, the enemy is trying to bring division, but we declare unity over you. We declare unity over the body of Christ right now. We say he is nullified in his words. We stop and halt right now. Those chariots of fire are coming down right now. The special forces of heaven are being released and commissioned to come against and war on your behalf and come against the enemy. For the battle may not be over, but the victory is yours. And so I declare right now over your life that every single thing that is in that old garment, in your old life, in your right now, in your being that you are busy releasing to the Lord, we cover it with the blood of Jesus. As you've repented, you're covered with the blood of Jesus. Some of you may say, why do I need to repent if Jesus has already done it? Surely I don't need to keep this repentance thing. Absolutely you do. It's because of the cross that we're able to by grace repent. We're able to make right. We no longer, we have to not have our consciences seared with sin. We can actually come under the blood and say, Lord, with sincere hearts, I repent. Forgive me for doing this. Forgive me for doing that. Taking repentance is taking responsibility for our actions.
Amen.
And that is how we grow and learn in Christ. Amen.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah. Shingarama. So do that right now. Yes, 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 yes. I see a lot of people saying, Kunama Shenda. Yes, yes. Keep it going. Church, come on. I tell you what, every time you repent, you defeat the enemy. Every time you make right, you defeat the enemy. Every time you do that, more love of God is poured out. There are new garments being poured over you. Now that you've done that, lift your hands up right now. Lift your hands up. Yabba Shakaraba. Right now, receive those new garments. Even if you still have to do some repenting, begin to receive those new garments.
Yes.
Come on. I spoke about this on Friday night at Sozo. God is releasing these new garments. Some might call them mantles. I'm not ready to call them mantles yet because God is releasing mantles. We spoke about that previously. But these are the new garments that are being poured out. In other words, this is the new self that is being put on. This is the glory of God that's going to be manifest through you. The new garments are the new self because God said you are a new creation. Ora ma shakarabai. We're going to stretch our hands out over you right now as we close this broadcast. We're going to stretch our hands out over you right now. Bride of Christ, get ready. Where you are, lift your hands up. We're going to impart an anointing over you right now of oil and fire and glory. We say we release these new garments upon you right now in the name of Jesus. We impart a new fire to come into your lives right now. Where there has been a flicker and a little bit of a flame, we say, Lord, thank you that you are releasing a new fire upon your people. Thank you, God, that you are creating burning desires in the hearts of your people for more of your glory to be released on this earth. Lord, forgive us where we have been complacent. Forgive us where our hearts have grown cold. Forgive us, Lord, where we've been stagnant. Forgive us where we've been distant. Forgive us where we've been, Lord, in a place of being subdued by the enemy instead of subduing the enemy.
Amen.
Right now, we subdue you, Satan, and we put you under our feet like Genesis 3 says. And we say the church of God will prevail. Arise, bride of Christ. This is your hour, the Lord would say. Arise, for I am sending my angel armies on assignment. They are coming to commission and align my bride, making ready for my coming and for the harvest of souls in Jesus' name.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Now receive that oil, receive that oil, receive that oil, receive that oil, receive that oil. Receive it. Stretch your hand out with
thank
me,
you,
prophet.
Jesus.
Rababa rebo sekambere dadaya mashoto resaya mai.
Receive it, receive it with your hands up. Oramashe kabasindai. Undalala braba, the gates of hell will not prevail against you. Shikaraba, I've called you my own. Shindana mandorobo, bought with a price, sealed by my spirit, says the Lord. Yamasho korebakate. Yabasho kabasete.
Yes.
Jesus, thank you right now, Lord. Touch them right now.
Thank you, Jesus. Breakthrough, breakthrough,
yes,
breakthrough.
Yes, yes,
breakthrough,
yes.
Breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. Breakthrough upon breakthrough, yes, upon,
yes,
breakthrough.
Yes, yes.
If you need to cry, yes, I pray, yes, that, yes, that you cry, break down to breakthrough. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Yeah, yeah, thank you, Lord. Yeah. I see that in my spirit right now. The Holy Spirit is falling upon you, showing you things, broken hearts being restored. Thank you, Jesus. Forgiveness come. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Breakthrough. Breakthrough, breakthrough. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on,
Lord.
Give the Lord a shout tonight. If this word has blessed you, just put there, I've been blessed tonight by,
yes,
the Lord of glory. Put it in the comments.
That's good.
Put it in the comments. Begin to make your declarations known and heard. Come on, so that God can begin to bestow on you the crown of glory that is yours in,
yes,
Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you.
You,
the
Lord.
Power of God is falling.
Yes.
The power of God is falling.
Hallelujah.
Touching,
thank
the
you,
bride.
Jesus.
Touching the bride.
Breakthrough. Thank you,
hallelujah.
Jesus.
We,
hallelujah,
bless you. We bless you all in the name,
amen,
of Jesus. Please, can I ask, if this has blessed you, please share this broadcast. Please also have a look on our YouTube channel. If you can go there and subscribe. We're really trying to get our subscribers up. And also, please know that this broadcast by tomorrow will be on YouTube. This broadcast will go on YouTube. The enemy tried to prevent it, but this broadcast will be on YouTube tomorrow. Hallelujah. Please share it from there too.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. We
God
love
bless
you.
God bless you, TNL family.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bye-bye.